The school opened in 1823, and since that time we've had a strong tradition of underpinning teaching with science. School has two major functions. We have to educate and we have to advance knowledge, and these are inextricably linked and fundamental to what we deliver in terms of teaching, research and clinical work. What we've created out here is, you know, is a centre of excellence in both clinical work, teaching and research, and that involved taking a number of key strategic decisions, and one of those was in 2002, where the veterinary school became part of the medical school, and that sort of meets the needs of the One Health agenda. In other words, one biology, one health, one medicine, where work that's done in human medicine can translate to veterinary medicine and vice versa.
So in bringing together the activities of human veterinary pathologists, we will produce a unit which will be able to do things that nowhere else in the world can do, which has the ability to really understand at a fundamental basis the processes of disease. So there's an enormous amount that vets and medics can do for each other in understanding what goes on. And I think it makes, as a teaching and training environment, it makes one which is really rather unique, because this is not just a traditional medical school or a traditional vet school, but a conjoined activity where, of course, we do the traditional things, but we do them in a broader sense with a broader series of interactions.
Another strategic decision was taken in 2008, where the Roslin Institute was incorporated into the university portfolio. The majority of the school's research is now based in the Roslin Institute, and the director of the Roslin Institute is now the director of research for the veterinary school. This has been fantastic for us because enhancing our own research by incorporating the world-leading research at the Roslin Institute means that not only does that enhance our research portfolio, it means that the undergraduates actually have the benefit of being taught by some of the finest researchers in the world.
The Roslin Institute and Dick Vet, which are obviously very closely partnered, they are both world-class brands in their own right. And this is with our partners in this precinct, the Scottish Agriculture College and the Morden Research Institute, this is the largest aggregation of animal sciences in the world. The Roslin Institute is literally world famous, and it's world famous amongst the general public, forever linked to Dolly the sheep. But in reality, our scientific reputation is based on what's called quantitative genetics, and that's breeding animals that are better suited for animal production, for productivity, and in the world where we're facing food shortages, that's a rather more important thing. We still have actually a lot of research that owes its origins to Dolly the sheep. A lot of stem cell technologies, there's actually a company called Roslin Cells that came out of Roslin, that is the major source of stem cells for human therapy. So we're still in the space of understanding developmental biology, and it's still important. But in the modern world, working towards improving animal production and in a sustainable way is probably the most important thing we do.
Veterinary medicine is not an apprenticeship. Essentially, our students are taught by the very best people in their field. We strongly believe that science underpins veterinary medicine. There is absolutely no doubt about that, and that's what we can provide on this campus. So people are taught by the leaders in their field, and it is, I think it's unmatched in veterinary medicine.
Most of the preclinical teaching in Dick Vet is now done by people from the Roslin Institute, including me. So I give the occasional lecture. I'm sure I'm a confusing lecturer, but I think the students do get excited by talking to people who are actually doing the discovering and finding new things and are excited by it. So I give a specialty lecture as well as the routine things on basic biochemistry, where I talk about my own work and where I'm trying to understand the immune system and how it works. And I get students coming up afterwards asking me questions. The vet students are some of the brightest students you'll find. And it's stimulating for me as well as them to sort of interact with people who are still asking questions.
So where we're situated here, we're obviously right next door to fantastic hospitals. We've got a great small animal hospital just next door, large animal hospital with equine and farm animal facilities, and of course the world-renowned Roslin Research Institute just across the road. Now teachers and from all of these areas will come in and our students will be exposed to that sort of leading edge research and also clinical work, which really means again that their experience is second to none here. I could go on about the facilities, but I think our students really appreciate what they have and what we have access to here.
Attracting good quality staff to any veterinary school worldwide is always a challenge, but what we can provide here for the staff is an incredible research infrastructure in an incredibly rich environment for both research and clinical work. It's not all about financial reward. What they have here is the Edinburgh experience. Living in Edinburgh is a fantastic city. You're part of one of the best universities in the world, Edinburgh University, and you're on the best campus in the world for delivering veterinary medicine.
The student welfare is obviously paramount. So when we think about the student experience, it's not just about their academic ability, it's about their overall experience of their 4 or 5 years that they spend with us. So each one of our students will have a personal tutor, and the personal tutor system is embedded in a house system. So we're trying to create a sense of family, a sense of belonging, a sense of support from staff, but also peer support from other students, which I think is really important. So we have a student welfare committee, which is very much student-led, but staff also sit on that committee and we talk regularly about student welfare issues. So student welfare is very high on our agenda. We consider ourselves really a real global player in veterinary education. So we do attract students from all over the world. We have a really wide diversity and I think that really enhances the student experience here actually, because students learn from each other. Students come in with degrees and those students have different experiences and different strengths in particular areas, and they can really help support each other as a peer group actually. So I think it's a real strength to have that diversity of students working with us.
You reach the top and you've got to keep going further up. You've got to get better. And so in the research side, we've seen that beyond our interdisciplinary centres, there's a higher level of activity in institutes, where we bring a number of centres together. We don't allow the centres to become new departments with walls around them. We blur those boundaries. We get increasing interaction. So for the vet school, there is the Roslin Institute and all of the activities that underpins in fundamental science relating to veterinary activity and how that then impacts on teaching.
We don't see this as the end of the story, we see it as the beginning. We really want the best campus in the world for veterinary medicine. And, you know, I'm confident we have the staff and the infrastructure now to achieve that.